Gayatri Prajapati, a former cabinet minister in Uttar Pradesh, has been denied bail by the Allahabad High Court. Prajapati was convicted of rape and sentenced to life imprisonment by the trial court. He had appealed the decision, requesting bail until the case was pending. But High Court rejected his application after reserving the decision on September 10th. Prajapati's trouble began in 2017 when the Supreme Court ordered the registration of a case against him and six others for gang rape, threats and violation of the POSCO Act. The victim, a woman from Chitrakoot, alleged that Prajapati raped her and exploited her minor daughter, taking photos and using them to blackmail her. The Allahabad High Court decision is a significant blow to Prajapati, who served as Minister of Transport and Mining in the Akhilesh government. His case has sparked widespread attention, highlighting concerns about corruption and abuse of power. Former Bihar Chief Minister Lalu Prasad Yadav faces more legal troubles as the CBI has received approval to prosecute him in the land for job scam in the railways. On Friday, the CBI informed Rao Revenue Court that the Home Minister had granted permission to prosecute Lalu, though approval for other accused is expected in 15 days. Special Judge Vishal Gogne urged the CBI to expedite the process. The next hearing is scheduled for October 15th. Earlier, on September 5, the CBI told the court that while permission was granted for two cases, approval for prosecuting 32 individuals, including Lalu and R.K. Mahajan, was still pending. The CBI filed the final charge sheet on June 7th, naming 78 accused, including 38 candidates who secured railway's job. Lalu is accused of facilitating jobs in Group D position in exchange for land transfers to his family and a related company, AK Info Systems, during his tenure as Railway Minister from 2004 to 2009. The ED has also summoned Lalu, Tej Pratap and Tejaswi Yadav to court on October 7. The Jharkhand High Court has reserved its decision on the case regarding Bangladeshi intruders in the state after hearing arguments from all parties. Senior Supreme Court lawyer Kapil Sibbal, representing the Jharkhand government via video conference, urged that the central government's affidavit lacked data on the entry of Bangladeshi intruders into Jharkhand. He also noted that a similar case is pending in the Supreme Court and accused the petitioners of using the PIL for political purpose. The PIL was filed by Jamshedpur resident Daniel Danish. Solicitor General Tushar Mehta, representing the central government, stated that census data showing a decline in the tribal population in Santhal Pargana had been submitted to the court, pointing to possible infiltration. The central government also informed the court that a meeting between the Home Secretary and Jharkhand Chief Secretary is scheduled by September 30th to discuss forming a joint fact-finding committee. This committee will identify illegal intruders in border districts and arrange their deportation. The bench, led by Acting Chief Justice Sujit Narayan Prasad, has now reserved the final decision. During the hearing in the old Rajendra Nagar coaching incident case in Delhi on Friday, the central government told the Supreme Court that a committee has been formed to look into the arrangements of coaching institutes, which will submit its report soon. A bench of Justice Suryakant and Justice Ujjwal Bhuiya directed the high-level committee appointed by the central government to present interim measures to prevent such incidents. The court has given the committee 4 weeks' time for this. The Haryana and Uttar Pradesh governments have also been asked what steps they have taken on this matter. The bench directed by Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Delhi governments to inform the court about the policy, legislative and administrative changes to prevent such incidents from happening again. A bench of Justice Suryakant and Justice Ujjwal Bhuiya said that a similar initiative should be taken in the entire capital to prevent incidents like old Rajendra Nagar. If needed, we will issue instructions to prevent incidents like old Rajendra Nagar across the country. The Supreme Court had taken sumo to cognizance of the matter on August 5 and issued notice to the Central, Delhi Government and Delhi Municipal Corporation. The Supreme Court, while referring to the death of 3 students in a coaching center in Rajendra Nagar, had expressed its displeasure over the negligence of safety standards in coaching centers. The Supreme Court had said the coaching centers in Delhi have become death chambers. Let us tell you that the students were studying in the basement library of Rao IAS Study Circle when three students got trapped in the sudden water in the basement and died. The Delhi High Court has ordered a CBI inquiry into this matter. Swati Maliwal faced setback as the Delhi High Court dismissed her petition challenging a trial court decision on illegal appointment in the Delhi Women's Commission. In December 2022, the trial court had ordered corruption charges against her for allegedly misusing her position to appoint acquaintances, including UP workers, to the commission between August 2015 and August 2016. On Friday, Justice Amit Mahajan rejected Maliwal's petition, along with the petitions of two other women also facing charges in this case. The Supreme Court has postponed the hearing on former Union Minister Menaka Gandhi's petition challenging the election of Samajwadi Party MP Rambuhal Nishad from the Sultanpur Lok Sabha seat in Uttar Pradesh to September 30th. During Friday's hearing, Menaka Gandhi's senior advocate Siddharth Luthra requested additional time to present relevant decisions, leading the court to adjourn the case. In her petition, Gandhi alleges that Rambuhal Nishad failed to disclose all 12 criminal cases against him in the affidavit submitted with his nomination. She has also filed a separate petition challenging a provision of the Representing of the People Act regarding the deadline for filing election petitions. The High Court previously dismissed her petition for being filed after the deadline, prompting her to appeal to the Supreme Court. The Uttar Pradesh government has presented key arguments in the Supreme Court regarding madrasas education following the Allahabad High Court's decision to abolish the Madrasas Education Act of 2004, which is deemed incompatible with fundamental rights and secularism. This ruling has been appealed in the Supreme Court. The government asserts that students in the madrasas can only qualify for jobs requiring 10th to 12th grade education. According to the SCERT syllabus, mainstream subjects are taught only up to 8th grade, with no requirements to continue these subjects in the 9th and 10th grades. Students in these grades can select only one subject from options such as mathematics, home science, logic and philosophy, social science, science or TIB, which differs from madrasas board curriculum. In its affidavit, the Uttar Pradesh government has declared that the Kamil and Fazil degrees awarded by the Madrasa Board are not valid for government employment, arguing that these degrees do not equate to undergraduate and postgraduate degrees from universities. As a result, students with Kamil and Fazil degrees are limited to eligibility for high school and intermediate level jobs. Watch our special programs and share the videos to stay updated with daily court proceedings.